Guys, welcome back once more to Franbo. As usual, I don't know where to go. That was strange. Did you see that flash there? So I guess I just have to click around once more, trying to find my way through this endless maze of where the hell could the numbers for the nurse be? The eyes are looking around. Excuse me, I need your help. Of course you do. What can I do for you? Oh, really? Did I not click this thing before? And it said, oh, I'll just help you find your cat, blah, 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 blah. Can you tell me what illness the creature who has the ticket number 2 suffers? He's in the waiting room, waiting. Let me see. I see him. From what I see, it's not really an illness. It's just a headache caused by low levels of agony in him. Wow, but is it possible to help him somehow? I need this ticket. Yes, crying all the tears you can cry until you fill this bottle will do. But don't forget, the tears must be caused by real sorrow. That wouldn't be a problem. I'm in a very problematic point in my life. I thought everything was going to be better when my kitty and I got home. But now, everything is so confusing. Aunt Grace is totally crazy. Talking with her was horrible. I really trusted her. I don't know what I'm doing, what I'm to do now. Mabuka said I was selected for something. But she fell asleep again and wouldn't answer my questions. I need my kitty. Mr. Midnight Hugs are the biggest comfort in my life. I just want to find him so we can go back to a tryst and be happy.
That is so comforting.
Lovely pain, so profound. The bottle's now filled with your tears. Give it to the creature that has your ticket. Go now. Time does not wait for anybody. Thank you. I'll be going now. Goodbye.
I can't believe all I had to do was click the frickin' eye. Okay, let's feed him my tears. Hey, have a bottle of my tears. They're pink for some reason.
Here, drink this. You'll feel much better. Oh, trying to poison me? Ha ha ha, how lovely. Let's see. It tastes like the most profound, the darkest elixir I've ever tasted before. Give me more, give me more. No, leave me alone. You promised me the ticket if I helped you.
All right, there you go. Wow, he actually has tact.
Tact?
He's honorable in his agreements.
Thank you, your tears taste absolutely delicious.
Number 2?
That must be the number display.
It's my turn to die. Let's use this. Let's go in there. Do we use it with...
Hello, patient number 2. We're doing all we can to save you. Do you have an appointment? Well, not really. You told me to take a number and wait. I'm sorry. We don't help sick people without an appointment. But I'm not sick. I lost my kitty and I want to find him.
A lost kitty? Don't worry, that's a natural reaction to your sickness.
You're lucky, though. Many lose their minds instead. Huh? Lucky? But how do I get an appointment, then? Aw, you just call me. Here's my card with the telephone number.
Ugh!
Why must I call you when you could take my appointment now? Oh, that would be silly, because now I'm waiting for you to call me.
Ah, all right, I'll go make the call, then. If my number passes, by the time I'm making this stupid call, I'll be so ticked off. Okay, here we go. Let's examine this. Do I have to remember the numbers? Do I have a pen nearby?
Please have a pen nearby.
Okay, this will have to work. Let's examine. I'm not even going to try to pride myself by trying to memorize it straight out. Let's see. 0, 1. zero. No, okay. 0, 0, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 1, 7, 2, 7, 6. Oh. 0, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 1, 7, 2, 7, 6.
Oh, hello. Yes, you told me to call to make an appointment. It's Franbo. I'm available now. No. Yes, I actually do have a pair of eyes.
Really?
Okay. I'll see you in a minute then. Great. Thank you. Bye. Yes, bye.
That just wasted just 4 minutes of my lifespan. Well, not 4 minutes. That's an exaggeration. Let's check the recording. I'd say about 2, 3 minutes. 2 minutes at most.
Hello, patient number 2. Do you have an appointment? Yes, Franbo is my name. The appointment is now. Let me check the archives. Yes, there you are. The doctor will see you in a minute. Go through the door to your right. All right, thank you.
It's a little concerning. Oh. I'm sorry. Wait. Which one is saying that? Her or him?
I'm sorry, did I scare you? You look quite pallid. Phew, yes, what a nightmare. You look like a healthy human. Oh, thank you, I guess. Now, if you don't mind, I have an appointment.
I don't mind actually, because it's none of my business. Look at you coolly walking back to the reception room. Oh, Ramor, we've meeting again. You haven't chosen to end your life yet? Isn't the pain you feel enough? I hope my voice acting has gotten a little better throughout the series.
Are you? You're Ramor, aren't you?
I haven't gotten a chance to introduce myself properly. Sadly, I cannot be seen in the third reality for a long period of time. I am Ramor, the terrible black. Prince of Darkness.
I know who you are. Don't try to act like nothing happened. Did you kill my parents? Where's my cat? What did you do to Dr. Dern?
I enjoy immensely seeing your suffering drip out of your eyes. I feed from it. You're the manifestation of my desire. I can use you for whatever I want. That sounds like a pedophile. Don't be a pedophile, Remor. She's 11.
You are under my power. That's not true. Not anymore. I won't allow you to trick me anymore. Tell me, why did you kill my parents? Why?
You are assuming that it was I that did such a terrible thing?
I saw you that night outside my window. It must be you who did it.
You trust your eyes too much. Haven't you learned that human receptors are weak? Yo.
Let me tell you something. This is some scary stuff. Because if he is saying what I think he's saying, which are human eyes are weak, everything around you is kind of like a manifestation of what you want to believe or what you think you see, then there could be monsters around every corner. There could be dark, shadowy figures just kind of like touching your hair without you seeing. And I see stuff in the dark. So what if those things are the things that my weak human receptors cannot see? Okay, mini rant aside, let's get back to this.
Your body is fragile, easy to corrupt. Ramor, that is super. Well, I kind of expected this. But, was this necessary? Why is her foot all the way over there? Why is blood on this wall in the shape of a fire thing? A.
No, it can't be. Stop it.
Fuck no, bitch.
I didn't do it. I didn't. It wasn't me. Stop it, please.
She cares. She does not give a single fuck. Who was it, my darling, who killed your parents? The dull little critter must suffer and die before becoming a star. Stabby, stabby, make it fabby. Can I get some water? I haven't killed my parents. I haven't. That monster wants to trick me. I know. Everybody is crazy around here. I have to find Kitty and leave. Let's go to the only open door. It's the only logical thing to do. Mr. Midnight! Kitty, my darling, I'm here for you. Are you alright? Kitty, answer me. What's wrong with you? Meow. Meow. Why won't you talk to me, Mr. Night? Mr. Midnight, please don't do this to me. Purr. Purr. Talk to me, Mr. Midnight. This isn't funny. Is she finally going back to being normal? Wow, she finally can't talk to her cat. That's a little sad. It's her only friend. Parents are dead. Wait, can I shock him? Can I kill him? Isn't this place, isn't it, you must get out of here so you can talk to me again. I'll take you to Aterista, my darling. Palantris can help us. I promise you, nothing will tear us apart again. Meow. Oh, Kitty, I'll be right back. I must help Dr. Dern, alright? He seems to be in trouble. Dr. Dern, are you alright? Sir, wake up, please. Dr. Dern, wake up. Are you alive, sir? What should I do to wake him up? Shock him! What does this lever do? Ooh, ouch, electroshock. Dr. Dern, are you alright, sir? Wake up, please, Dr. Dern. Okay, that's the same talk sequence. It's Jesus. Hee hee, maybe this will wake him up. That is deranged, you're crazy. Oh, that is... She's crazy. I 100% support the theory that she killed her parents. I have since the beginning of playing this game, however long ago. She's insane. Look at those eyes. Ah, damn, what was that? Don't worry, Dr. Dern, it's me, friend, and I just injected you with a mystical, magical syringe. What? I can't see very well. Fran Bell, sir, from the Oswald Asylum. We were at the cemetery, remember? Fran? What happened? Why am I tied to a chair? What have you done? Oh, I'm trying to help you, sir. The big monster brought you here. We must go. Come on, Fran. Monsters? I don't feel like playing games. All right. It wasn't a monster at all. Just let me help you. Who are you? Oh, I know you. But what is she doing here? I thought you tamed her. Ah, I did. I told you she was a hard one to tame. Do you want me to get rid of her? Get rid of me? Aunt Grace, why are you talking like that? Who is this old man? It's either that or she murdered her. Her cheekbones are too cut for her not to be part of murder. Who is this old man? How lovely. You sound like your mother when she was young. My mother, do you know her? Who are you? I'm Dr. Oswald Harrison. I know everything about you, Fran. Oswald? From Oswald Asylum? Yes, Fran, the same old man. But why do you know my mother and my aunt? Well, many years ago, I was studying the magnificent complexity of twin siblings. Lucy and Grace were part of my study, but helped me find the key to success. The key? Did you know that my mother and father were murdered? Of course, yes. Remmer did a great job. His power of manipulation is extraordinary. What I don't understand is how you can be so calm about it. It was you holding the knife, after all. I'm not calm, sir. I knew it was Remmer all the time. But why does he haunt me? Remor is a manifestation of your weakness. A blinded, powerful manifestation of your fears. But why would the monster kill my parents?
Because your parents were interfering with my work. But I actually did you a favor. You are suffering, and pain is connected to growth and strength, friend. Oswald, please, let's do what we need to do. Aunt Grace, please don't be mad at me. We're family. Let us go. My kitty and I can find a place to go without bothering you. Please, just let us go. Yes, you're right, Fran. I'm sorry for being so hard on you. Come on, let's go now. I do not trust her, but she's taking my cat. And I suppose I need to get my cat. Screw you, old man. I'm gonna go get my kitty. Are you dropping my cat off of that balcony? Fran, my dear, listen to me. You must know, Dr. Oswald only wants the best for you. When Lucia was pregnant with you, he knew you'd be a very special girl. He told us to take good care of you, but your mother betrayed us. She wanted to hide you from us. She thought we wanted to kill you, but that's not true. Dr. Oswald really wants to give you the best. But for that, you must allow him to try a little experiment on you. And then everything will be fine? Of course. But there's still one thing we must take care of. This little traitor must go. This bitch dropped my cat. You! How dare you! Ugh. No! No, kitty! I knew it was gonna happen. I can't even be sad. Come on, Fran, stop weeping. The cat is dead now. But he was my friend. You killed my best friend. You also helped to kill my parents, didn't you? Didn't you? How can you live with yourself? I hate you. I hate you. Oh, Fran. Fran, this is not the healthiest of behavior, but since that bitch dropped your cat, I shall allow it. Stop it, Fran. Help. Help. Please, help. Her arms, there's something wrong with them. Oh, hey, Dr. Wheelchair. You have a gun. My back is to you. Don't you dare touch Grace, you little monster. Well, this is a rather startling turn of events. I've been shot. Oh my goodness, she's totally insane. Bring her to me, I'll do the experiment while she's still warm. These people are crazy. I need to extract the brain right away. Is this like a strange lobotomy? Fran, are you alright? What have you done with her? She tried to kill me. You were right about Fran, Dr. Dern. She was sick. But she's bleeding. Let me take care of her. No, you won't. She's mine now. Everyone here is strangely like a pedophile. Yep. I've been waiting for this moment for many years now. Looking for the right child, the right brain. Now I have her. Nothing can stop me. Except for Edward. Deus ex machina. Oh, Fran, everything will be fine. Who are you? I'm Edward, the one many children talk about. But you're not human. Ectobro, ectoprote, polontres mocanist. Gorska. Edward, I found him. Oh my goodness, stay away from the girl, leave her alone. Is this the real Mr. Midnight? Little Fran must be cured. Do you think he can use the same body? Yes, she's not completely gone yet, here I go. I thought she was kidnapping me. Oh, Mother Mobuka, you took the innocence of the child. Fran is now dead and alive. Wake up in darkness, Fran, you'll be able to walk towards the light.
This is very strange. Oh, hey. Thank you for putting my soul back in. Or taking it out. No, it's definitely going back in. And the dogs started barking again. What happened?
Itward, Palontras, my head hurts. Mr. Midnight, how? You're alive, my kitty. I missed you so much. Please tell me something.
Fran, we must go now.
Go? All right. Dr. Turin, look, this is Itward and Palontras. I told you about them, remember? I told you they were real, see? Can you believe me now?
He can't hear you. I think he's under the power of Mabuka now. We really must leave now.
We're going on a ship called Palontras. But can he come with us, please? He's been really nice to me. He really wanted to protect me and help me.
We can't bring him with us, I'm sorry. But what we can do is make him believe that all of this was a dream. That he will wake up and none of this really happened. But he won't remember you, Fran.
I see. Well, that's okay, I guess, as long as he's safe.
That's very kind. You're finally seeing beyond your desire. You're becoming one with everything. Your parents would be very proud of you.
You really think so? Aw, thank you, Palontras.
Now, let us send Dr. Dern home.
Marcel Dern omnum vecma sindunsla ecto.
And poof.
Goodbye, Dr. Dern.
Let's go now, Fran. There's so much you must see and learn.
Hee hee, that sounds like fun. Let's go, kitty.
I still don't know many things. But one thing I do know. That between guilt and fear, I choose happiness.
Strange. Is this the end? Well, you see, that's felt very anticlimactic, but it's probably because I've been playing it for so long, and I don't really know what happened. Did I murder my parents? Because I'm sick? Or did Remor possess me to murder my parents? Or did Remor murder my parents? It's a very beautiful game. It was very nicely crafted. And the music was good. Everything nice and illustrated and stuff like that. Everything was very nice, all the prop assets and whatnot. But the story was at points very nice and concentrated and everything made sense. But other than that, some parts just did not make sense, and the ending kind of sounded a little strange. And I don't know if I'm talking complete crap because my brain is so out of it, or it's very meta, this game being done, but thank you for watching. I suppose this has been a very nice adventure, and this is the first complete game I've finished on this channel. Hopefully, I will be able to complete more games in the future, but it's very nice. Thank you. Thanks, everybody. Let's just let this ending screen go by so we can see all the beautiful faces that have contributed to such a lovely game. And I don't know how long this will last. Okay. That's enough of it, I suppose. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.